Eyal Levi here with URM Academy Nail the Mix, and I am going to unbox Unanswered by Suicide Silence, which is on Nail the Mix this November 2019, being mixed by none other than the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Tue Madsen. And this is really cool because I feel like this is one of those recordings that kind of defines a genre. And I like recordings where no fucks are given, and this is clearly that. There's something almost punk rock to it, and I mean that in the best possible way. According to Tue, this was recorded in about 15 minutes, meaning they did three takes live with no click, and that was that, and that's what you get. Like, this band just banged it out in the studio, and there's something beautiful about that. And something that I always found interesting or special about Suicide Silence was the amount of energy that they brought. Like, back in those days, metal production was starting to get very sterile and lack of feel, and fake sounds were kind of the big critique about where things were headed. And here's this band that blew up, that was recording live and sounded real. And that energy was just infectious. So much energy. So before moving any further, let me just show you that there are zero plugins on this. And I'm just going to play you what it sounds like raw right out the gate. And then we'll break it down a little bit. Slams pretty hard, doesn't it? And the fact that it's actually played is part of why it slams so hard. It's got real human energy. So first thing I want to point out here are Mitch Lucker's vocals. And Mitch, RIP, one of the best for sure. And this is what I'm sure that these are compressed on the way in, as you can tell from the waveforms. But I mean, this is what he sounds like without any mix processing.
Yeah, but with a curse your name! Yeah, but you.
This is this life.
Yeah!
And I'll say you fucking. Because I do it.
Just killing it. Brutal. I mean, God, it sounds like a demon. All right, let's check out these drums. Looks like a pretty standard setup. Kick, snare underneath, four toms, stereo overheads, hi-hat, an ambient mic, and a distorted room. These are very, very solid drums. They're just hit hard and they have really good groove. I like how raw they sound. I like the high-pitched snare. And I think that the challenge here is going to be to not overcook them straight up. You got to get them sounding huge. But if you overcook this, you're going to ruin it. You need to go easy on this because it already sounds brutal. Now, something interesting here is that there's three guitars. So every guitar has a low, a high, and a room. And I imagine that it was supposed to be left, right, center. But I'll let you hear what they each sound like. Low. Pretty fucking low. And here's room. One thing I've noticed, we have worked with Tue Madsen before, and I know that he didn't produce this, but last time he was on Nail the Mix, he did a Meshuggah track that was also recorded live, and it also had guitar rooms. Just interesting bit of trivia here. But together, and see, the thing is, I'm not sure what balance he had on these guitars, but I'll just let you hear the guitars on their own. And I'm sure you'll agree with me that they sound really, really heavy. So it's not overly technical or anything like that, but it's really, really heavy and really nasty. And I know that a lot of you are going to be tempted to notch the hell out of it and just clean it up. And yeah, sure, you got to do some of that. I mean, it is mixing. Like, you got to mix these tracks. But go easy. Like, the moment that this starts sounding too clean or too sterile, or even a little sterile, is the moment that you have ruined this mix. I'll let you hear the bass. We got just called bass one and bass DIR and then bass two. So let's see. So three basses as well. Oh, wow. I mean, there's the proof that this was recorded live. You can hear the snare and the drums in the bass mic. So that's the DI. So you have two bass mics and a DI. I know some of you are going to be a little concerned about that bleed, but I would not be concerned about it at all. If anything, it's going to help you glue this together a little bit more, but it's not loud enough to really be much of a concern. And hey, you can always use the DI if you want to. Let me hear the distorted room, because I really like this. This right here is what will help you also glue these drums together. How heavy is that? You can really, really feel the power in that kick and the power in those riffs when you just hear it stripped down like that. So it's no surprise that this band is crazy live, because you hear them raw and they still sound powerful. Like, this is what they actually sound like. They actually sound like a nasty, powerful, brutal as fuck band. And it translates live. And I can't say it enough, but I wish that more bands got good at playing in a room, because then you could have an effect like a Suicide Silence or a Behemoth on your audience. Notice no double, and he just sounds vicious. Fire on the Honestly, there's not much more for me to say. I mean, this is a very bare bones recording, but it's kind of the magic of the whole thing. No click, straight up, raw. I love it. Again, be careful not to overdo this one. It's already pretty great raw as is, and if you overdo it, you're going to ruin it. So good luck, happy mixing, and this is Suicide Silence Unanswered on November 2019. Nail the Mix with Tue Madsen.